vitamin A has different forms. One is vitamin A1. Then we have A2. We have neovitamin. A alpha and neovitamin A beta. These are forms of vitamin A. This is generally used for vision. It helps in creating proper vision. The major portion of vitamin A is vitamin A1, which is also called as retinol. And it readily oxidizes, is highly sensitive to oxidation and readily oxidizes or auto-oxidizes, doesn't require generally any reagents. When exposed to UV light, it generally gets ruptured or gets destroyed in presence of UV light, and it is an optically inactive vitamin. This is optically inactive and gets destroyed when exposed to UV light. Just as such, sunlight will not be rupturing its structure, but UV light will definitely rupture the structure. This belongs to the class of carotenoids. So it is a dicarbonoid and it belongs to apocarotenoid groups. Structure in case carotenoid ki tarah hote hain, thoda bahut similar to carotenoid. It has double bonds, five double bonds in conjugation. That is what makes it sensitive to visible light. Agar inke double bonds kam rehte to, maybe we could have seen what is happening in the UV region and not in the visible light. This becomes more sensitive for the visible region. Synthesis for this, it takes two steps. First step is the synthesis of required Grignard reagent. Step one is synthesis of Grignard reagent, and that can be done by using methyl vinyl ketone. Methyl vinyl ketone that subjected to first reaction with ceramide, sodium in liquid ammonia, then with acetylene, when proton is extracted, and finally hydrolysis will give rise to the introduction of triple bond. Introduction of triple bond. This can further be proton. This hydroxy group can be extracted via H2SO4. H2SO4 being a good dehydrating agent. So hydroxy group will be extracted. This undergoes resonance with the help of this double bond, or it can undergo resonance with the help of this triple bond also. Positive charge will be on the terminal carbon. This is primary cation and the tertiary cation. Tertiary is more stable. So in this case, what happens? This particular primary carbocation will undergo hydrolysis, and also there is a reduction of double bond will happen. This is further reacted with ethyl magnesium bromide so that the adequate Grignard reagent can be formed. Two molecules of ethyl magnesium bromide are required. This proton is extracted, and here the hydroxy group is extracted. So it will be a double Grignard reagent will be formed. Here this will be a A molecule. This we will be using in our step 2. In step 2, we start with beta ionine. This molecule is available in market, so we can easily use this for the synthesis of vitamin A. This is reacted with chloroacetic acid, ethyl ester of chloroacetic acid, to undergo Darzan's glycidic ester condensation reaction. Darzan's glycidic ester condensation reaction aapne last semester mein padha tha. It forms epoxide. Well, addition of this chloroacetyl group over here, there will be a formation of an epoxide also. Methyl group is retained. Oxygen forms the epoxide. COOD. So we get a epoxy ester. This epoxy ester undergoes hydrolysis, first a basic hydrolysis and then an acidic hydrolysis. For hydrolysis of ester, acid, which undergoes decarboxylation in presence of copper, but here also when this hydrolysis is happening, basic hydrolysis will result into formation of a keto group over here. Alpha keto acid will be formed. This alpha keto acid undergoes decarboxylation such that yahan pe decarboxylation hone ke baad jo hydrogen hai wo attach ho kar ke aldehyde group banayega. So we will get this aldehyde. This aldehyde then isomerizes so that this double bond is attached here and becomes a conjugated with aldehyde group rather than conjugating with double bond. If alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde would be formed. This further reacts with the Grignard reagent that we had prepared. ये जो टर्मिनल वाला है इसमें OH होगा और यहाँ पर ये अटैच होगा यहाँ पर हाइड्रोजन को जगह पे विद कार्बोनिल ग्रुप इट विल गेट अटैच्ड. This will be a diol, secondary alcohol hydroxy group and a primary hydroxy group. This undergoes reduction. So that a triple bond ka reduction over here means cis isomer milega. Concentrate dark status. This now comes to here because यहाँ पर अभी इसका conjugation form नहीं है as it was previously keto group was there so conjugation था यहाँ पर अभी वो conjugation loss हो गया इसलिए ये double bond इधर shift हो जाएगा so that it is now in conjugation with a double bond again. This reacts with acetic anhydride so that preferentially this terminal or primary hydroxy group will get acetylated. And we need to do modifications with this hydroxy group. This water undergoes a rearrangement of the secondary alcohol. ये hydroxy group यहाँ आएगा और ये double bond इस तरफ जाएगा. So allylic rearrangement happens. This is preferred because it increases the conjugation over here. Three double bonds are in conjugation, and now if we lose a water molecule here, then it becomes a five bonds will be in conjugation. So it readily loses water. Further, this is a retinol acetate. The last step for vitamin K synthesis will be, this is our retinol acetate. We need to hydrolyze this in basic medium. This is how retinol or vitamin A can be synthesized in laboratory. So this was for all the vitamins.